أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and good evening. Alhamdulillah, we meet again to continue our practice on the Surah AsSajdah. So to enable us to actually understand directly from the Quran text, which will allow us to appreciate more the miracle of the Quran. Only those who actually understand understand the words of Allah directly from the Quran and what we are trying to do will be able to appreciate the miracle of the Quran context as well. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Ayat, we continue with Ayat 9 and the A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Thumma sawwahu wa nafakha fihi min ruhi. وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ ثُمَّ then a continuation of the previous two ayats where we say الَّذِي أَحْسَنَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقَهُ he who perfected every single thing that he created and wabada when he originated the creation of man from clay, from moldable clay, then he created his progeny from the extract from the despised water, right? So it's a hit from sperm, right? Summa sawahu, summa then he fashioned him, or he actually sawa means balance. So he proportioned him. I mean sawa, balance, stable, those are the words. So he proportioned him. Wana fahafihi, and he blew or he burst into him from Ruhihi, from his spirit. Okay, so we have a fi'l madi sawahu. So the subject is he or huwa that is referred back to Allah, and this who is the object refers back to insan. Same goes with nafaha. Nafaha, the subject, the dual of the verb nafaha is Allah. And the object in this case is the form of a phrase, min ruhi, from his spirit, into him. Okay, so this phrase of ruhi, okay, is a mudaf ilayhi. So it doesn't mean that ruh is part of Allah, but it belongs to Allah rather. Same goes if you go for an example like you have Zaid's pen, which is mudaf ilayhi. Kalamu Zaidin is Zaid's pen, but that pen is not part of Zaid. It's something that you can separate it from Zaid. Okay, so that is actually the concept of mudaf ilayhi. So when you say Ruhi, it's not actually that the spirit is part of Allah, but is that the spirit belongs to him. The spirit that he created, that's created by him. Okay? So please understand that clearly. Right? Because there are some people who say that spirit is part of Allah and we have a part of Allah in us. That's not correct. Okay? Aqidah wise also, that's not correct. Okay? Waja'ala lakum, and ja'ala he made. Okay? Different from halaqa. Halaqa he created, waja'ala he made from something that's already available to something else. That halaqa he created from nothing to something. Okay, but ja'ala actually convert from what's available into something new. Okay, so waja'ala lakum, and that means from the soul. Okay, waja'ala lakum, he made for you, he made for you, as-sam'a, hearing, wal and al-absara, sight, and wa and al-afida. Al-afida is a feeling, okay, feeling or conscience. Something that is intangible, abstract, that comes from the heart. Okay, the heart, the sense of the intangible heart, not the muscle that pumps blood in our body. Okay, so that's why. So it's what we call hearing, sight, and feeling. Okay, so these three factors are what you should be able to apply and lead you to appreciate or feel guilty. Show your gratitude towards Allah. But the answer is qalilan ma tashkurun, little whatever that tashkurun, you are grateful, tashkurun, you are grateful. Qalilan ma tashkurun, little from what? This is a mawsul. Whatever that you are grateful for. Right, so we can look at the translation. Then he proportioned him and put into him from his created soul, and made for you hearing, vision, and hearts. That is intellect. Little are you grateful. Okay, right. So we go to the next ayat. وَقَالُوا أَإِذَا ضَلَلْنَا فِي الْأَرْضِ Inna lafi khalqin jadid. Wa qalu, and they said, okay, qalu is a fil madi, home being the subject, and because this wow should have plural. So qalu, they said, and they said, a is a question, a is a. When? Is it when? Is it when? Dolalna. Dolalna comes from the word dolala. Dolala means lost. Dolalna means we are lost. Dolalna means we are lost fil earth, in the earth. Meaning after being dead and buried into the ground and turned into dust. That's what the concept of this loss is. What it means. Okay, after being dead and lost in the earth. Inna lafi okay. Verily inna verily we. So this answers the questions. Okay, so the translation is will we. Inna lafi assured, when you have inna, which means verily, inna lafi large la taqid, indeed lafi khalqin jadid, in khalqin jadidin. Khalqin jadidin, khalqin is a noun, the khalqin, the creation, jadidin, new, so it's new creation. New, jadid is the adjective, so it's new creation. Okay, that that we believe in will be in a new creation. So the translation in this, it will be, and they said, is it that when we are lost in the earth, then after we are lost in the earth, we are buried and turned into dust, just like any other dust, then will we be in a new creation, right? Bal in English will be nay. It depends on the context, actually nay. Sometimes we say definitely. Okay, then it means definitely. Bal, bahkan, bal. Hum bilika in Rabbim kafun. Hum, they bilika, with, likai. liqa'i meeting. Liqa'i meeting. Ila liqa' ma'asyama ila liqa' bumi lagi. So liqa'i rabbihim, this is under, this is mudah mudah filai. We know because liqa'i, there's no tanwin. Rabbi is majrur because there's mudah filai to liqa'i. Of course, rabbihim, when you have a pronoun, a dhamma, connected to a isim before it, then it's definitely a mudah mudah filai. So these are two mudah mudah filai of the three words here, between liqa'i and rabbi and him. So liqa'i rabbihim, with the meeting of their lot. With the meeting of their lot, kafirun, they rejected. They rejected, they disbelieve. Okay, they are disbelievers. Because why kafir is termed as disbelievers? Because you can see there's a small alif there, ka, so it's an active participle. It's a fa'al. Okay, so this kafirun, disbelievers. Okay, if you say mu'minun, disbelievers. Kafirun, disbelievers. Okay, so that's why it's translated as disbelievers, because it's an active participle. And those who disbelieve. Okay, so the transition will be, and they said, is it when after we are lost in the earth, will we be created anew? Will we be a new creation? Khalqin jadid, new creation. But they, with the meeting of their Lord, they are disbelievers. Okay? Cool. Yatawaffakum malakul mawtil ladhi wukila bikum summa ila rabbikum turja'un. Cool. Say. So this is a command verb. Say. This is a command given to Muhammad. By extension ourselves also. When people question about when we are doing da'wah. The question that people this question may be posed by our prospect. Okay, so we will say, cool. Yatawaffakum malakul mawtil ladhi wukila bikum. Okay, so this sentence is long. So we have yatawaffa, is a fi'l mudhari, yatawaffa. Yatawaffa means tawaf, wafa. Fulfill of your, so this yatawaffa, wafa means cause you to die. Okay, yatawafako. Okay, will actually pull the life out of you. Yatawafako. So yatawafa, we have malaku and isim in the mafu. Since mafu, it will be the subject of yatawafa. So this malak means the angel, one angel. So malakul mauti is mudah mudah filai. So the angel of death, malakul maut, the angel of death. Okay, but then the sentence continue. The sentence of that, and that is that, or who? Ukila. Ukila is a isim fil madi. Fil madi majhul, passive verb. So that is ukila. Ukila means it's linked to you, or Wakil, okay, let's see what's the translation. Has been put in charge, okay? Okay, that's put in charge of you. So one wakila, right? Wakila. Wakila put in charge. Wakila biko, with you. Okay, so there's one sentence. Okay, we'll say, O Muhammad, okay, the angel of death that is put in charge of you, in charge with you, okay, will cause you to die. Yatawafan. Summa, then, ila rabbikum to your Lord, rabbikum your Lord, to ja'un, you will be returned. So da'un is a fi'l mudari, it's also a majhul or a passive form, to da'un, like wukila. Wukila means charge to you. Okay. Wukila means his place or his appointed for you. Wukila appointed for you. So to da'un, raja'a means return, raja' rujuk. Rujuk means return. So to da'un, you will be returned. You will be returned. Okay, so you can see the meaning. Say the angel of death who has been entrusted with you will take you. Yata wafa kum is wafa, cause you to die, will take you. Then to your Lord, you will be returned. Okay? So that's the verse ayat 11. Okay, we'll continue. Walau tara ilil mujrimuna nakisuu ru'usihim 'inda rabbihim. Rabbana absarna wa sami'na farji'na. Na'mal salihan inna muqinun. Walau tara and law if. Law if. So it's a syarat form law. Walau tara. And if tara you see. And if you see. Okay. Walau tara. And if you see. Some possible thing that will happen is when al-mujrimun comes to the word jarmin, those who committed sins, or we can also some consider it to the sinners, al-mujrimun, those who committed crimes, al-mujrimun, so it's a case in point. It's an active ism with a dhamma and then ra in the kasra, so it's a file. So it's active. Those who committed crimes or those who are sinners. Okay? Al-Mujrimun. So, right? The terminals. Right? So that's the terminals. Yeah? Nakisuru usihim. Nakisu fil madi. Nakisu. They actually lower down. Ru'usim, their heads, their necks or their heads, ru'usim. Okay, so nakisu fil madi ru'usihim. Right, nakisu ru'usihim. Something is not right. Yeah, ru'usi is nakisu fil madi ru'usi. This should be ru'usahum. Ru'usi, let's see what this verse means. Their heads. Ru'usi. Ru'usun. Ru'usun. So fil is a jamak taksim. So jamak taksim. Ru'usi. Jamak taksim. Okay. Ru'usim, nakisu ru'usim, this is a fil madi definitely, it's a noun, or that's a will hang. That's why I'm saying will hang. Okay, this is a noun, no wonder. That's why I'm questioning why this ru'usi is in majrur. It's majrur, because if it is in the verb, this one should be in fatha, bin nasa being the object. So nakisu is a... Okay, what's the root word here? Is nakasa. Nakisu. Is a jamak taksir. Of both jamak taksir, there's mudah-mudah-filai. It's a special spelling here. Okay, nakisu. Normally when it's a jamak, I wish not jamak taksir with nakisu na. And then if it doesn't have if it's mudaf in the head, the nun will drop. And in this case, the nun will drop and it's fixed with alif here. This place replacing the nun to show that it's mudaf if you like. Okay? Nakisu ru'usihim. Okay, nakisu ru'usihim. So the hanging of their heads, the hanging down of their heads. So nakisu. Inda Rabbihim, inda inda Rabbim, in the presence of their Lord. Okay, inda means besides or in the presence of their Lord, right? Before, right? Before their Lord. Okay, before their Lord. Yeah, before their Lord. Okay, so this is the first sentence. And if you see when the criminals hanging down their heads, okay, with before their Lord, okay, then you should continue. The hanging down of the heads, I mean the heads, because should be sentence, I mean the literal meaning would be the hanging down of the heads before their Lord. So they already feel lost and ashamed. Okay, they feel very regretful. They were actually in front of their Lord, in front of Allah, they will just look down, right? And Rabbana, this one is a dua, is a they actually supplicating Rabbana, right? So actually there's a word they call kalu. There should be a kalu, they say, or they pray da'a. So this something hazaf, yeah. So the Rabbana actually is a because normally with Rabba we have a ya Rabbana. Okay. So ya Rabbana, oh our Lord, Absharna. So it's a fil madi, Absharna. We have seen. Absharna, we have seen. Wasamina, and we have heard. Farjina, then irjina. Therefore, irjina. Return us to earth in the sense. Na'mal, we will amal. Na'mal, so salihan, good deeds, do good deeds. We will do good deeds. Inna mukinun. Verily we mukinun. Also it's a fine mukinun kalau yakin. We will be the ones having faith. I mean really yakin, have true faith. Okay, this is okay. Certain, okay, very certain. Mukinun yakin. Now certain. Right? So but notice here, na'mal here. If we were sukun, so it's a jazam. This is because lau is actually a conditional sentence, but lau does not actually turn the fi'l mudhari after it is jazam. So that's why you should just you have alif masrura, yataro. Otherwise, you just taro. Walam taro, alam taro, alam taro. Is it not that you see? Okay. Alam tah, did you not see? Okay, so but this law is whether it's also conditional but doesn't convert cause the fi'l mudhari to be jazam. But when you have a condition, there's a jawab, there's the answer, there's a response to the condition. So the condition starts in the Habib Rabbana Absana Wasamina Fajina Na'mal. Na'mal meaning is that we definitely will, okay? We definitely will, na'mal. So otherwise it will be na'malu. So na'mal means jazam. So we surely would. We surely would do good deeds. Verily we are now certain, or we have full faith. Which of course is useless after in the year after. The regret after the year after is useless. Okay, so the sentence here is, and if you will see when the criminals, the hanging down of their heads before their Lord, then they will say, oh our Lord, we have seen and we have heard, therefore, please return us so that we will act, or we will do solid and good deeds, verily we are now certain, we have fulfilled. Okay, let's see how the sentence translated. If you could but see when the criminals are hanging their heads before their Lord, saying, our Lord, we have seen and we have heard. So return us to the world. We will work righteousness. Indeed, we are now certain. Right? So that's the translation. Now we go to the next sentence. It should be the last sentence, inshallah. وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَآتَيْنَا كُلَّ نَفْسٍ هُدَاهَا وَلَكِنْ حَقَّ الْقَوْلُ مِنِّي لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ وَلَوْ شِئْنَا, case again, وَلَوْ, and if شِئْنَا, if we wanted, وَلَوْ شِئْنَا, if we wanted, spell mud, and if we had wanted, okay, or we wanted, la'ataina, verily, la, this is la tawkid, ataina, we would have given, or we have, who have made, ataina means to give something. Kulla nafsin hudaha, kulla nafsin, also in mudaf mudaf lay, all men, all people, man means man and woman as well, all humans. Hudaha, hudaha, their guidance. Hudaha, their guidance. His guidance, I don't know, because kula nafsin is singular. I mean, we talk about every soul or every man. Hudaha. So hudaha is here. That goes to nafsun. Nafsun is actually a feminine word. Okay, it's a feminine word. It's referred to as feminine. That's why I say hudaha. So his guidance. Okay, its guidance. Okay, its guidance. Right? Its guidance. Hudah, hidayah, its guidance. So this one complete jumla. Walakin, and but, haqqal kaulu. Haqqal kaulu. Haqqal is haqqal kaulu. This is spelled madi, I mean, make it truthful, okay? It's true, it's a verb. Sometimes when you translate to English, it's a problem because when you translate English, it becomes a noun. So it actually doesn't do, I mean, that's the best it could do. It doesn't give the full meaning of the sentence, of the intended meaning that Allah wants in the words of the using Arabic. This haqqal kaulu, haqqal is a fi'l madi. Al kaulu will be the subject of haqqa. Okay, al kaulu. Al kaulu means the word. The word. Al kaul, word. Al kaulu, the word. The word means, al kaulu minni, from me. The word from me means my decision, okay, my determination, okay, what I ordain, okay, so from Lord, from the God, from Allah, from what I have ordained, okay. Al kaulu minni la amla anna, okay, la amla anna la sunnata, okay, verily, amla anna is a fil mudari, I will make it full or fill. So this is tawkid with la amla, okay, the nun sakila, even nun shadda, you have to give it a greater emphasis. So it's double emphasis for this word, la amla anna. Verily, I will definitely fill jahannam, okay, jahannam, minal jinnati wan nas, from the jinn and men, ajma'in, all of them, both of them, yes, ajma'in, okay, together, ajma'in, okay, right? So So let's read the sentence here. And if we had wanted, definitely we would have given every man his guidance. So they will be guided to the truth. But the word from me, my word, is truthful, is true, or is becomes true, or hardcore, made to be true. Okay, hardcore, he made it to be true. And then the kalu means the my the words from me or my decision will be true. So it's also a difficult translate to English because hardcore is a verb. Okay, true, comes true. Verily, I will definitely fill Jahannam, hellfire, from among the jinn and men, all of them, all together. Okay, let's see how it translated fully. And if we had will, we could have given every soul its guidance. But the word from me will come into effect. Okay, that's my hardcore will come into effect. That I will surely fill hell with jinn and people all together. Okay? So alhamdulillah, we have covered about 5 sentences. So inshallah we will continue with our practice next week, same time. And hopefully this will be able to help you to understand the Quranic text. But before you actually go do the practice, you have to actually watch the playlist of the topics on the understanding Quranic grammar and morphology. So from there, then you practice, then you gain more and more confidence and more knowledge, and you become more conversant in understanding the syntax and the flow of the Quranic language. With more reading, more reciting, and with more analysis of the words, like what we are doing now, we should be able to improve yourself from time to time as time goes by. And we have the whole lifetime to read, actually. Because remember that for every letter that you recite of the Quran, even though when you actually practicing like this, if you get 10 credits, 10 shawah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the practice learning Arabic from the Quran is the best way to actually to start mastering the Arabic language. Okay, I'm so sorry because the Malay version of this practice actually has been going on since 2017. We are now in. We started from Al-Fatiha, we are now in Surah Al-An'am in the Malay version, and I'm teaching the 57th batch right now, the 57th batch for since the last 5 years, and I'm just starting to try to convey the knowledge in English, which I find that some vocabulary or some words I try to fill to translate sometimes it's not exactly correct or exactly correct in the sense. So that's why some have to refer to the meanings given by the apps. But again, some meaning of given by the apps also is not actually accurate. But as time goes by, when you read and you can compare the words, like actually this app allows you to actually, let's say, which word, la'am la'anna. Okay, when you click for more, okay, they will give you the come from mala, muli'at, okay, la'am la'anna, muli'at, mala, muli'at. So you click for more. Okay, this will go one time, al-intala, mali, two times. So you can actually see where this happened. Okay. this word occurs in the in the Surah 50, Ayat 30, and it's the fifth word in the ayat. Okay, so actually you can compare the meanings of this word as it's used in the several other verses in the Quran, then that will help you to actually understand the fuller meaning of the word. Okay, so that's how you learn slowly, understanding the Quranic text. So I do attach you to subscribe to our YouTube channel, BAQY, Understanding the Quran, Studying the Quranic Text in 12 hours. So you can actually watch all the topics there as we practice, and inshallah, it will help you to appreciate more the miracle of the Quran. So till we meet again, wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah, wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you.